Working the 450-acre Kemsi mine site for the past 3 years.
Buenos dias.
Cancio, his son Eric, and miner Jesus are keen to get Parker's advice, and in return, Parker could find an investment opportunity.
Wow, muy grande.
And is this like a cooperative? Are they all part owners, or is it a corporation?
Es una mina privada.
Privada.
Donde yo soy el dueño.
How deep is that from the top?
¿A cuántos metros está el oro? Ahora podría estar hasta los 25, 30 metros.
Are they going to end up taking this whole hill out?
A futuro sí.
Eventually.
El oro es mucho.
Así.
Así es.
Sí. Ah.
Es muy irregular.
For thousands of years, gold trickled down from the Andes into a series of ancient riverbeds that are now buried deep within the ground of Kemsi. The riverbed channels are sporadic and hard to locate. So miners, like Cancio, dig huge holes searching for the mother lode.
Let's go down there.
Yeah, should we get down there?
Vamos caminando por allá, entonces. Vamos por
allá. Lot more ground here.
Yeah. They have at least three different pits going on at the same time. They've got a bunch of dump trucks, at least two excavators that we've seen. There's not massive jungle that you're like cutting down 500-year-old trees. And there's a bunch of ground. So, we'll see.
Cuando él era chico, él venía a los cerros a buscar pepas.
Children. Really? When you were, when he was a kid?
Yo soy de acá. Yo nací acá, me crié acá. Por eso había, siempre supe que había oro acá.
Wow, amazing. This place is interesting. Really, really interesting. The major gold deposits that are left in the world aren't sitting on the surface anymore. They're deep. And that's exactly what this place is. This is giving a hell of a lot of food for thought.
Esa es la carga que se lava.
From here up, that's all waste rock.
Wow.
So they've only got like 10 feet of pay.
Wow, mucho. I don't know what waste is.
I'm kind of curious how hard that is to dig.
The highest stuff.
Yeah, like all the waste. Think you can ask that?
No.
¿Está difícil para el máquina? No.
Suave. Blando, suave.
Blando.
Suave. ¿Quieres operar?
Sí.
Claro.
¿Fea en él?
Claro.
Con los ojos cerrados.
Oh, yeah. 6,500 hours. The Yukon, we have this huge issue with permafrost that costs us tons of money. Like, we spend millions of dollars a year dealing with permafrost. They don't have that problem here. So I'm like, okay, the pure volume of dirt that needs to be moved per ounce is probably going to be more, but they're easier yards to move because you don't have this permafrost issue, right? And so if we can find huge volumes of material, I think that that would tip the scales towards this being more economical than what we're mining in the Yukon. I suspect. I need to spend some time on it, but moving dirt is not that expensive. Down here, it would be, in some ways, even easier to dial in a system, I suspect.
Hey, chupalo.
¿Cuánto?
Granos.
Para semana.
200 a 300 gramos, aproximadamente. Hay veces que no hay nada. Nothing. Nada.
Really? They can go for very, very long time. It's very irregular, and they can go for sometimes weeks with nothing.
With no gold?
With no gold.
Shit.
Sometimes. They have to wait until they get back on it again.
Es así. Venimos a trabajar teniendo fe y esperanza de que tengamos buena producción. La idea siempre es buscar una buena carga y de ahí estar libres totalmente, sin deberle a nadie, trabajar para nosotros mismos.
It's a very big land package they've got, pretty much untouched, and I think that there's a lot of potential.
El chute.
Vamos, vamos.
Chute. Sí, vamos. Vámonos.
Acá es donde viene la volqueta a descargar la carga de lavado. No es el gran lavado que quisiéramos, pero es lo que podemos hacer y lo que tenemos.
After surveying the ground, Parker is kicking the tires on the most important piece of equipment.
Some pretty thick material sitting on those sluices, isn't it?
Yeah.
Hay pepas que pasan. Hay ciertas pepas que pasan. Por eso necesito mejorar mi lavadero. Mi lavadero es precario por ahora.
El problema es la inversión que conlleva.
La mina crea, o sea, da buena ganancia. No niego que con la minería logré muchas cosas que nunca en mi vida logré. Pero a la vez trae dolor de cabeza, ¿no? Deudas, más inversión, hay que comprar maquinaria, o sea.
Yeah, because as soon as you make some money, some machine breaks down or whatever happens and it just goes right back out the door, right?
Por eso te digo, prefiero ser albañil o agricultor, floricultor, que minero con deudas. Llegar a la concesión fue muy difícil. Fue una etapa, una crisis económica de mi vida. Siempre tenemos deudas, pero llega el momento que saldamos las deudas y a veces la ganancia es mínima. A veces la ganancia es mínima, pero siempre responde. Nunca la gente se va sin cobrar. Siempre intentamos, yo al menos trato de siempre pagar a la gente para que sigamos trabajando.
Cancio's hinted that he's open to me getting involved in some way. I don't know if it would be a partnership or an investment or what, but I think the biggest problem is it's just like we're really close to the end of the trip. We've moved an excavator and a wash plant into this other creek. There's definitely a lot to think about for me. The riffles are in the wrong way around.
Are they? Oh yeah, that doesn't make a vortex, does it, like that?
We put this in the other way around with this end leading, and that creates like a vortex in the top end. The gold will catch under that lip when it's reversed.
Tiene que dar vuelta.
Dar la vuelta.
Sí, está al revés, dice.
Truth of the matter is, these guys don't really have a clue of what they're doing. They're very, very new to it. They're talking a lot about how they've only been doing it for a few years. Now, when you hear that, and you make that comparison of experience between these guys and Parker, that makes this place a very, very interesting place to be.
Hoy esto nomás sacudimos, ¿no?
Esto todo.
What? Oh my. No male.
Shit. A veces más grande, más chico. Pero normal son de ese tamaño, siempre está saliendo.
Mate, I think we're in the right place.
Y hoy sí fue una buena producción.
Salva la semana.
I think it's a big gamble for this place to really like cross over into a big functioning gold mine.
Whoa! Look at that.
But there's a bunch of gold. It's a little bit better than what we're mining in the Yukon on the average. And there's a bunch of ground. And that's like a surefire way to get a gold miner excited.
After a 7-hour shift, Cancio's crew pulled 3 ounces of gold.
That's good, isn't it?
Yeah. It's not bad.
Worth $5,100.
If you guys are open to it, I'm really interested in spending some more time here working with you guys, if you're open to us coming back.
Bienvenido, no va a haber ningún problema. Genial para nosotros, porque sabemos que tenés mucha experiencia y eso nos vendría bien. Y combinar las dos cosas sería, creería que lo podríamos sacar lo mejor.
Sí, muchas gracias. Yeah, like I'm super pumped to be here to have found this. They seem like awesome people. They seem very down to earth and honest.
Wow. Some of the richest ground that we've seen on this whole trip.
Yeah, this is awesome. We have to make some fast decisions. I'm gonna push hard for the group to come here. This is what we've been looking for.